supposed to be here. Whoa, we ain't supposed to be here, no.
Cause I grew up around the killers, grew up around the kids. Cause I grew up around the killers, grew up around the kids. Cause I grew up around the kids, grew up around the kids. Cause I grew up around the kids, grew up around the kids.
Love you, love.
Ils n'investissent pas assez dans le futur, dans le long terme. Ils ne réinvestissent pas dans l'économie. Dans bien des cas, ils ne...
This is the scene. As it unfolded, terrified passengers running for their lives at the airport. And this photo here shows the damage.
Hey, left side!
Shock is like we've seen a lot of terrorist stuff. You know, we see people with guns and dogs every day. It's just not the size that they have now. Like even coming out of the airport, you know, they got their hands on the guns ready.
Yeah.
But you have to take precautions.
And nobody enters and nobody gets out. We don't have control. I can't hear, so.
To be honest, I actually feel safer now.
Yeah, really?
Yeah, I actually feel,
because
I don't.
That's because knowing here, I used to go here on holiday with my parents and everything, knowing how things go around.
Yes.
Yeah. What scares me is because it's small.
Mm-hmm.
So the reaction time wouldn't be fast.
Right.
There is no space.
Right.
So if, for example, they put a bomb in the center, we are all done.
In Paris, that thing happened. That was the reason it's a studio. People, I was on Instagram. Like, I'm in the studio, I don't know what's going on.
You don't know what was happening.
I didn't know, but I was in the studio. And he was like, yo, call your family, like, it's just a bombing out there. And the bombing was, I was just taking pictures earlier that day in that same area. So it was kind of, it was a little scary.
So you cannot even, like, travel normally anymore. Even in trains, you have, like, soldiers and also police with dogs.
Yeah, you guys picked us up at, that's where you was at originally? We wasn't stepping foot outside. We didn't know where we was going. We was like, nah, we just gonna stay right
scared.
Here.
You know, I woke up this morning at 6 o'clock. I must travel from Holland to Belgium.
Right.
And all the way along, it's the first time that I saw, we are not used to see guns. We like, we really have another gun way of living. My father himself is American from Washington, D.C.
Okay.
And living, like going there, it's completely different. The black people here, they don't shoot each other.
Right.
You don't just die like that.
Right.
Or it's not dangerous here.
Right.
People that play gangster, you laugh because we have too much advantages, good schooling, everything good to go play gangster actually. So when somebody does it, people look like, why would you do that if you live in a country when you don't have money, they give you that. When you don't have nothing, a house, anything you don't have, you get it. You even have people that help you to find the work.
We need more bottles, hell my, hurry up, tell them wrong brows here, hottest in America, give me some.
They've been shoot, like every time we went out, they shoot it, you know? So I was thinking, like, if I was supposed to die, I would have already died, right?
Yeah.
And I stayed there like 3 months, so every dance hall party or something, there was always, maybe twice a week, somebody that would shoot. And, you know, like, it's funny, like, everybody goes on the floor. It was really new for me.
So, yeah, we're here in Belgium. People are scared to go out. It's crazy. It's really crazy.
Yes.
There's nothing to be scared of.
Yeah, you mean people with heart. If you're not scared, it's nothing to be.
Party because of the
situation. Yeah, cancel this party.
Right, we're gonna be back though. We're gonna take care of
it.
Damn, every time you guys go overseas, it's an attack. Like, what are you guys doing? You gotta
bring this red flag, right?
It's crazy. But we, you know, we good-hearted people, so we don't, you know, we just wanna go have fun. We're not worried about that. At the end of the day, we want to take the fans, their mind off what's going on, just for that little time.
Yeah, because a lot of people did really their best, and that's why we made it happen. First, it was about to be canceled. There were really specific requests and people that really wanted to come. We said, okay, at this point, we're going to try, and we really, the three last days, we have
like I said, we our family were more, you know, scared than we were. He was like, let's go.
You're gonna be really in Brussels. We're gonna pass where it happened.
Then
they're like, you're gonna see the real parts where they organized the securities and everything. That's why we also took the hotel a little bit next to the name in case something's going on.
Right.
We can. It's the best we could do.
Big fella, fill it up with the M's. Timberland, come on, hooligans in Harlem. Dead right, get your head right, crowd here every night. Fuck me good, get a couple pair, yeah right. Those jewels ain't none of that damn light. I'm in the pure white, hopping out of one flight. Every nickel back sold, I'm a PC. Niggas wanna be me, all the way to DC. Take off records, tall Wappy VP. I'm in a range coupe, sea color, seaweed. Mommy hopping, looking like a mermaid. This is Hermes, yes, she's homemade. Bobby running around with chicks, I look so amazed. Mommy said she wanna freak off, okay.
I was like, yo, they probably ain't gonna let me go home. I'm stuck out here.
And how they feel the fact that you were booked right now here in Brussels?
My experience touring overseas has been pretty cool. It's never been really, like, scary. I feel like the promoters and people I've been around making their business will make me feel comfortable, you know, moving around. Even when I left Paris, it wasn't like, that time it happened, it wasn't like security was not like, crazy. Pretty normal, actually.
But we are 5 minutes from the airport where the
bombing
happened. Yeah. But they have the army from the
airport,
like, they just run. But it was, I was like, I feel like running because there is a. After university, I work at the European Union, and there is a metro stop, and they put a bomb there. And I was watching TV, and there was like a woman without a leg, and a 3-year-old child crying. And in the same metro, there was like a basketball player, and he had his legs and his hips all broken, and he was like trying to pull his legs in order to go to the. Child of 3 years old, and to take her, she was full of blood and dust. And, like, images, we are shocked because it's a small country. There are only 11 million people there. It's not even a state.
Me, because I heard the beat. I heard the beat. But they need to know. They need to know right now. That's time. Time to make money. Time to make heat.
Yeah.
Ouais, parce qu'il m'expliquait, comme je disais, comment la Ramoni est née.
Ouais.
Et non, le pot de champagne, c'était un truc de fou.
J'ai entendu ma main ballon. She don't like me.
And he's a biker, you know, like.
So tonight it kind of really scared a lot of people away.
Yeah. I don't know, it's like.
Are not the only one that came. There are other parties with me.
Like, I don't really be scared for some reason. I just be like, let's go with it. Like,
he's from New York. Why would you be scared?
Yeah, I guess that
way worse shit than this.
I'd be like, man, worse shit happening.
You had everything like that. Bombs. You got
shit every day. You know, all of them. So I'm like, that's what people wait for this island. Yeah.
Yeah,
they like, it's not the same. I say, no. People die every day on the news on goddamn Harlem, Bronx, Queens. Flying and bombing happens, you know, periodically. They shoot every day in New York City.
Yo, man, Montclair.
Yo, got your accent. Right,
I got my sleep flow right now. So we gonna get it together. We ain't getting no sleep. Drinking champagne all night. And you know, we gonna go vodka tonight. Tonight straight vodka. Got my man, Bonjour, papi. Euro papi. French tour, all the French. I got my sombrero on. She don't like me, I know what it is. All my friends, friends tour part two.
Yesterday was a little rough, you know, being that I was a bomb. Usually, a terrorist attack. People don't really like coming out in the club, going in to stay in the house. Went to the club, it was a little
light. Like, you know,
we asked the people that ain't scared come out, and the people that's, you know, a little shooken up by it, they stay in the house. You can't knock them.
How you say nice? Okay. Nice. Met value.
Met value.
Met value.
But you gotta roll the R. No homo. No. Met.
Met.
Oh, met.
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 M-E-R.
Yeah,
Mac.
Mac. Mac. Mac. There you go.
It's not the account. Oh, Mac.
We have like three morning days and tomorrow is Easter, so it's a whole mess, so we have to cancel. We also lost money ourselves because we did already booking to make sure that the artists come here with the hotels and everything, so it's a mess.
I mean, like I said,
you guys, you know, I slept only 2 hours in order to solve everything financially, also with the club, because the cancellation, the people that couldn't come. It's okay, like, it's just they were in panic, answering the companies, trying to stay good with them, you know. But everybody understands because it wasn't because of us. Also, I think there is a lot of fear. I think a lot of people are scared to go to the center, the metro. No, people taking it, but it's out, they close everything. And we have 3 national days of mourning.
Right. This is fun.
I need your
We're supposed to be
cause I grew up around the killers, grew up around the killers, cause I grew up around the killers, grew up around the killers, cause I grew up around the killers, grew up around the killers, cause I grew up around the killers, grew up around the killers.
Really beautiful places in Brussels too, but I don't think it's a good idea.